What's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Mr. Hoodat 1320, back with another video. Hey, first thing first, I want to say I apologize for the wait. Right now, you know, I'm in the process of trying to finish up the my wedding and stuff like that. I got my wedding is next month. I'm getting married next month, so I've been pretty tied up with work plus that, so I haven't had time to really upload anything since what I believe last month. But I'm back. I'm about to bring y'all some more exclusive content, man. So we got a 1320 out here right now. I'm gonna go ahead and give y'all a cold start real quick so y'all can hit that thing and run. All right, she's alive. Today's video is pretty much me discussing how much I paid for the 1320. Why did I end up getting the 1320? What other cars was I looking at during the time of me shopping for a new vehicle? It was a couple other cars I did look at, you know, I was considering buying over the 1320, but of course I'm a Challenger guy and the 1320 end up being on top. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get into that video, so I'll see you in a second. All righty, now let's go ahead and get to it, about how much I paid for my 1320, and what other cars I was actually looking at to buy during the time I bought my 1320. First thing first, a lot of people gonna be like, man, you could have got a Hellcat, you could have got, you know, something else with that, with the price that you paid for the 1320. But for the folks that's, I guess, the younger crowd, if you're buying your first car and you know you're not gonna keep that car and you plan on trading in years down the line, I'm telling you right now, I wish I would have listened to my dad when I first bought my car. I bought a 2015 Dodge Challenger SXT when it first came out. That's what I came from. I came from a V6 SXT. I had that before the 1320, of course. That was the first car I bought. That was the first car I actually purchased. And it was a V6. I ran the miles up like crazy. I was crazy upside down on the car. So those are some of the things you have to take into consideration when, you know, buying a new car and stuff like that, because you're gonna be upside down. I mean, as soon as the car gets off the lot, you know, it depreciates like crazy. So you're gonna lose out on, you know, big money when buying a brand new car. But if I would have known what I know now, if I would have knew that back then, back in 2015, you know, keep the miles down, take care of the car, stuff like that. Cause like I told y'all in one of my videos I had posted, I was driving that car like it was a V8, man. I mean, I was tearing that car up. I was always driving crazy in that car, but the car held up for a long time. I didn't have any issues with the car. Once I traded in, the car was fine. I think the only thing that was wrong with the car was I had a cracked windshield, but other than that, the car ran fine. I kept up with the oil changes and stuff like that. But you know, to cut a long video short, I'm gonna go ahead and let y'all know. So I traded the V6 in. At the time, I owed $13,000 and some change on the V6 when I traded in. Once I got to the dealership, you know, I pretty much asked them. No, matter of fact, I didn't even show up at the dealership. I didn't go to the dealership. I knew the car I wanted already. It was out there in Bremen, Georgia. I called over to James O'Neill, Dodge, Chrysler, Ram, and Jeep out in Bremen, Georgia. I called him. Buddy name was Nick. Real cool guy, real great salesman. I called him. I said, hey man, you know, I have a V6 Challenger that I was looking to trade in to get me a 1320. What's your out the door price for the car? You know, at this point I wasn't looking to get no deal because I knew I was already upside down. So I had a number in my head already what I wanted to pay for the 1320. I wasn't gonna go over that number. So I already knew what I wanted to pay. So you know, I called him and you know, he was asking, well, what's wrong with the car you have now? We need to get pictures and stuff like that. So before doing all that, I actually went down to my guy Caesar which is Matrix Revolution, where I usually get my car detailed. I know you guys seen, you know, a couple of videos where I was there getting the car washed and stuff like that. He actually detailed the car, did a great job. I believe he charged me like $150 to go through the whole entire car, go through everything, trunk, under the hood, everything, man. And the car was already in good shape, but trading it in, I knew I was gonna be upside down, so I was trying to get as much as I could for the car anyway. So I owed $13,000 for the car. Once I went ahead and got it detailed and stuff like that, and I went ahead and emailed those guys some pictures of the car, they was telling me, well, you know, what are you looking to get for the car? And I knew I wanted at least $10,000 for the car. Was I gonna get $10,000? Probably not. I mean, the car had 105 miles. I was at 105,000 miles on the V6. And the guy was telling me, well, we don't know if we can do 10. And I asked, well, what's the best you can do? You know, I'm already upside down. What's the best you can do? So he said, we can do 8. So at this point, I'm like, 8. I'm like, whew. I'm like, man, that's pretty low. Like, that's low balling right there. Like, it was a great car. I had some nice 22s on it. Nice looking car, man. But besides that, like I said, the car was in great shape. But anyway, they wanted to go ahead and they wanted to make the deal, you know. So I end up going through my bank and seeing if I can get the loan for the price that they was asking for the car. And during that time, I mean, the money, I was willing to put money down, but I didn't want to put any money down. And I would tell anybody, if you're buying a new car and you don't have to put money down, don't put it down. Like, keep the money in your pocket, you know, pay your car note, do whatever you gotta do, but don't put the money down if you don't have to. So with my credit score and my fiance credit score, we definitely came up on top. We had a great interest rate. I believe the interest rate was right at 4% for the term that we did. So a lot of people gonna be like, oh man, you crazy for doing that term, but I'm explaining why I did the term. So I actually did 84 months, and I did 84 months, and the car note came out to be $705 a month. So I'm currently right now paying $705 a month for my 1320, and the total price of the car came out to be $51,000, and that was because I was upside down. So once the outdoor price, I believe, was, let's look at it right here. So I got the paper right here. Go ahead and let y'all check this out real quick. All right, so okay, so total price was $47,775. Base price $38,000. Once you add everything onto it, that's where the $47,775 come from. So looking over this, I pretty much got everything that the 1320 has to offer. Of course, you got the drag pack, which was $39.95. Then the 8-speed automatic transmission, that was $15.95. And then you got the RT Scat Pack 6.4 liter Hemi V8 package, and that was $16.95. But for the most part, you know, I think that's a pretty good deal for the 1320. The car had 0 miles on it. It had 82 miles on it, and that was just, you know, people coming by to test driving and stuff like that. No big deal at all. I still feel like, you know, it was a pretty good price. So let's go ahead now looking at that. Now we're gonna go ahead and talk about the rebates and stuff like that. So of course the car had rebates. It's a brand new car, so we had all kind of rebates. The rebates took the car down to, I believe, I don't want to lie, I believe it was 44, maybe, maybe a little less, maybe somewhere around there. But anyway, you gotta think, I was already upside down on my V6 Challenger. So with that being said, I owe $13,000 on my V6. Okay, so that's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we talking about $5,000 in the hole right now. I could have put money down, but once the bank had already approved what I needed and out the door price was $51,000, I was fine. I'm not gonna put no money down. Like, I know what I can pay, you know. So I was fine with whatever they was throwing at me, because I knew what I can pay. I already had a number in my head. I'm like, okay, 51, it's not bad at all. And 705 a month, perfect. That's not bad. I can pay that, no problem. So once we did everything and, you know, we got all that taken care of through the bank, it was the easiest process ever. I think the first time, my first car I bought, the V6, I think it may have been just as easy as that one. Cause the day I went out to Bremen, Georgia, I came back with my car. And I had to go back to Bremen to drop off some paperwork and stuff like that, but it was just an easy process. It was no problem at all getting a car, you know. So another thing, you know, for for folks that's, you know, working on, like, continue to work on your credit, you know, if you got a good job, you know, to support your living habits, like, that's great, man. But credit is important. It's very important to have, you know, good credit, or, you know, if you're young and, you know, just build on your credit. You know, if you need help or advice, you know, like, holler at me, man. I'm telling you, because my dad, I remember when I was 18 years old, man, I used to always think, like, my dad being an a-hole, man, he always talking about credit, this and that, but he was right, man. I must say, like, my dad definitely got my mind right when it came down to credit, because he always told me, man, like, credit is very important. Like, get your credit up, don't do nothing crazy, man, make sure you're taking care of your credit. And I appreciate that till this day, you know what I'm saying? So for my younger folks, older folks, if you're looking, you know, you're trying to work on your credit and stuff like that, me personally, when I first looked at my credit score, I was buying phones and stuff and not paying them when I was younger and stuff like that. I actually went through Lexington Law. Some of y'all may not know what that is, but, you know, I went through Lexington Law, and they pretty much worked on my credit for a while, to the point where I was over a 720, you know, and finally got myself together and stuff, and, you know, and stuff like that. So if you're looking to purchase a car, man, I would definitely, especially a pretty, you know, a pretty high car, you know, when you hit anywhere from, I don't care, 20, 30, 40 grand, man, you need to, you know what I'm saying, have some credit behind it, man, so you ain't gotta give these dealerships all your money. You know, you don't have to sit there and pay them all this money, you know, putting money down on the car. Just pay your note, you know what I'm saying? You go up in there with good credit, you know, and get a good interest rate and this and that. And if it's a note that you can afford, go ahead, you know, do that. But make sure you work on your credit. But anyway, get back into this. So once I did that, like I said, I was able to get the car with no problem. Now, what cars was I shopping for before the 1320? So I went and test drove a wide body Scat Pack Challenger, which was a nice car, really nice car. But me personally, I didn't feel like I can wake up every morning, go outside and look at a lime green car. Like, I was just like, that's not gonna work. My fiance, she was just like, nah, babe, I don't think you really gonna be up to that every single day you wake up. So I was like, yeah, you know what, you're right. So I test drove it. It was a great car. It was a wide body. Out the door price, they wanted, I believe it was 53 or 54, and I just wasn't in my budget. Like I said, 51, that was it for me. I wasn't looking to go 51.5, none of that. So 53,000 was out of my price range. It was a nice car, but at the end of the day, it had basic interior. The interior was just that regular cloth. It did no leather, no Scat Pack on the seats. It did have Scat Pack on the seats, but it had the Bumblebee on the seats, but it was just basic. It was the same interior I had in my V6 when I traded that one in. But yeah, I wasn't feeling it. The interior and the outside was lime green. And actually, a guy that I follow on IG, he actually went and bought that same car at test drove, and he did some really nice things to it, real cool things to it. So salute to that guy. I couldn't work with that lime green. That's not what I wanted. I did drive the wide body Scat Pack, which I wasn't feeling. If it was another color, I probably would have considered buying it, but still not for that price, because I felt like other people got better deals. Only reason I was it was that price is because I was upside down on my V6. But anyway, so even, you know, after all that, I looked into the Mustang. Really nice car. I looked into the Mustang, of course, the V8 5.0. I looked into buying one, a 2019, and to be honest with y'all, they came out around the same price that I paid for this. No lie, it came up to, like, I want, with me being upside down, it was like still like 51, 52 or whatnot. And they were nice cars, really nice cars. I inquired about several of them, but I didn't go forward with the Mustang. And I watched a lot of YouTube videos about the Mustang, And one of the things that caught my eye was the ticking noise coming from the motor. And some people may be like, oh, that's not a big deal, this and that. But I wasn't feeling that. I was like, man, these people having issues with ticking, and nothing wrong with Ford at all. Nothing wrong with the Mustang. I love the Mustang. I love the body style of it and all that. So maybe one day I can even go back and get one. But during that time, that kind of like, I was like, nah, that's out the door now. What else did I look at? So we got the Scat Pack, the Mustang, Camaro. I did look into the Camaro. But to be honest with y'all, I've never ever like really been into the Camaros. Nothing wrong with Chevy or nothing wrong with the Camaros, but it ain't never been one of those things where I was like, oh, let me go get a Camaro. Now, I did want to go and test drive it, but I never made it there to test drive it. Because I hadn't already found the 1320, hadn't already looked up videos and stuff like that. So I was like, 1320 is where I'm going with it. But don't get me wrong, the Camaros are definitely nice. A lot of people ask, like, why didn't you get a Camaro? Look here, man. I've been in a Camaro and I can't see for nothing in this world out of the Camaro. Like, the Camaro is so compact, like it's not for me. I'm a big guy. You know, on camera I might look a little, I'm a pretty big guy, you know what I'm saying? So I wanted something roomy, something that I was already used to. And the Challenger, it fits me. You know, like my fiance say all the time, she can't really see me driving anything else but the Challenger. You know what I'm saying? Like, it fits me. But the Mustang was extremely small too, don't get me wrong. The Mustang was small too. It was kind of difficult for me to see out the Mustang, you know. But it definitely was pretty small. Once I finally was able to get inside the Mustang, I was like, man, good thing I didn't buy this car, because it is small. It's definitely small. But for the most part, you know, the Challenger is by far my favorite. Did I look at a Charger? No, I didn't look at the Charger. I've been in a Charger before, and I just knew it wasn't for me. I don't have any kids. I don't, you know, it's just me and my fiance, and I've always been into Challenger. I like the body style, but like I said before, there's nothing wrong with the Charger. I like the Charger. I like the body style and stuff like that. It's just not for me. I just like the Challengers or whatnot. But that's pretty much it. You know what I'm saying? Give y'all a heads up on, you know, what I actually paid for the 1320, you know, out the door price for the 1320. If you are interested in buying a 1320, you know, like I said, just make sure, you know, you're getting a pretty good deal on it. I have several cars right now. You know, I got a few cars. I got a few cars right now, so the 1320 is not a daily driver. I have put quite a few miles on it because I was driving quite a bit from here to Atlanta on the regular, to different car shows, hanging out with friends and stuff like that. So I did, within the last few months, I did put quite a few miles on it, but it is at a standstill now. The 1320 will be parked during the winter time. I actually got another car that I'm working on right now. It's in the paint booth right now as we speak. And some of you guys that do follow me on IG, you already know what kind of car that is. So some people may say I'm Mopar and Chevy, but y'all know it's Mopar for life. But yeah, I do have another car that I'm actually working on right now. Getting some work done to it right now, so you guys will definitely see that real soon. So, you know, just stay tuned for that, but it's definitely coming. But this video was not me, you know, showing off the car like I'm usually doing. It was just, you know, giving y'all, you know, just telling y'all, showing y'all what I actually paid for the car. Like I said, a lot of people may be like, man, this guy's crazy for paying what he's paying for that car, or that term is too long. But just know, I will not be paying on this car for 84 months. The plan is to definitely pay it off way before then. I pay more than $705 right now. I'm not gonna tell y'all how much I pay a month, but I definitely pay more than what I'm supposed to be paying, because I do want to pay the car off sooner, you know what I'm saying? Way sooner than 84 months. That right there just gave me, I was comfortable with doing that just because I wanted to have room in between there, you know what I'm saying, to work with. But the car would definitely be paid off way before 84 months. I plan on paying the car off, you know, pretty quick. You know, I'm paying more than what I'm supposed to be paying, pretty much. So if you do have it like that, if you can do that, it's always good. You know what I'm saying? It's always a great option to do. You know what I'm saying? Go out there and you know, if you working some overtime or whatever and you want to add a little bit more to your car note every month, that's fine. You know, that's pretty much what I'm doing, you know what I'm saying? It's working for me. But yeah, but like I said, you know, just give y'all heads up on what I actually did and what I went through and the process. But I do have more stuff coming to the channel, man. And like I said, I do apologize, but I really do appreciate every last one of y'all, man. We at 245, let's keep it going. When I bring the other car to the channel, you know, it may bring a whole nother crowd to the channel, you know, you never know. But the 1320 is here to stay, it's not going nowhere right now. You know what I'm saying? It's here to stay, it's not going nowhere. But I hope y'all enjoy my videos. You know, make sure y'all leave a comment, you know, like, comment, subscribe. Yeah, man, y'all just stick with me, man. I'm steady trying to bring y'all some content, man, but I definitely got some dope stuff coming to y'all real soon. The racing, all I got to say is the racing scene in Georgia is not yet over with. Like, it's got more coming, man. We got a couple more. We got about two more big events coming in Georgia, man, and I plan on being at both of them. So if y'all see me, make sure y'all show some love. But like I said, that'll be it for this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and that'll be it. Deuces.